Guys, I get it. Without money, it is definitely hard to prep. Myself, I'm definitely not rich either, and I have to watch every dollar that I spend on preps. But like I've said in other videos, there is ways to get, usually there's ways to get some extra money to actually buy some preps with. And like I've talked about before, go through some of your things and see what you have that you're not using. What can you set up to have a yard sale to sell to get some extra cash to go buy preps with? Go buy a few more cases of food, some more bags of rice, whatever you need. Maybe you can sell some stuff you're not using for enough money to actually go out and buy something extra to prep with. Who knows, you might come up with enough stuff to sell that you're not using, that's just been put back in a garage somewhere or storage shed, and have enough stuff you can put up for a yard sale or sell some other way at a flea market or something like that, and actually have enough stuff that you can sell for enough money to buy another Glock or buy an AR-15. But I don't know what you have, you might not have anything, but it's a good idea, if you possibly can, to go through all of your things and look at what you have and say, do I actually need this? Am I actually going to ever use this? Have I used this in the last couple of years? Is this essential to my own preps right now? And go through your things and see what you have and gather all those things up and see what you can sell. And then take that money and go buy some extra food items. I'm doing the same thing myself, like I said. I'm not rich. I don't have a huge bank account full of money. My books, I sell those books through my blog, MrCreekmore.com, and Amazon and YouTube here. But overall, those books bring in a few hundred dollars every month, and I get a few hundred dollars from my ads. I make about as much, probably about equal as much, doing this YouTube and blogs and books as I would if I was working at a job like McDonald's or Walmart or something like that. I'm not getting rich by any stretch of the imagination, but I keep going, I keep trying, and I do make enough money to pay my bills, and that's a good thing. But as far as having extra money to go out and just buy a lot of preps with, I don't. Most of my stuff I've gotten over the last 15, 20 years that I've been buying things and putting things back and storing things back and gathering up and building up over the years. It's not been just one big spending spree in a couple of months to buy everything. You can prep a lot cheaper than you actually think you actually can, but you might not be able to get all the nice fancy tools, the expensive things that you think you might need, like bug out vehicles and things like that. It takes time, and right now we're running out of time. It is really hot out here, guys. So it's a good idea to gather up and see what you can gather up that you have now to take and sell. You can set up on a flea market maybe in your area. You can set up a yard sale at your house. What I'm going to do, there's a business here in the county that it's a big, I don't know how large the building is, but it's a large building, and they've partitioned out sections inside that building, and you can rent a space inside that building. It's sort of like going to a flea market, except you just rent the space out. I think it's $60 a month to rent the space, depending on the size of the space. I think it may be $45 to $65 a month, depending on the size of the space you rent. And you rent that, and you take your stuff that you have for sale, and you put that in your booth that you have as you've rented, and you put your price tag on it, and you put your numbers on that, and the people goes in and shops through everybody's stuff. If they buy something that you have for sale, they take that up to the counter and you have your number and they write that down and put that money back for you. So you can have like a flea market yard sale type thing where everyone in the county comes to, and you don't have to be there yourself to actually sell what you have. You just get the stuff, rent the booth, and set it up, and they do the selling. That's what I'm going to do. I've been going through a lot of my things and seeing what I don't need, what I've had forever, and stuff that I've not actually used in a long time. And mostly what I've came up with is a whole lot of books. I got in the habit for a few years of buying books. Every week I'd buy a new book, and I would read some of those books and some of the other books I'd put back and actually not be able to read, didn't have time, didn't have the inclination to actually read those. But mainly what I've got for sale is a whole bunch of books. I went through every book I own, and the books that covers a lot of the books that you get, like homesteading books, prepping books, will cover a lot of the same topics. It's just a repeat by a different author on the same topic. You might find some new things in those books, but overall, a lot of things are simply repeated. And I went through and tried to find the books that I feel are like that, that I have other books to cover those topics. And a lot of novels that I've had that I've already read or don't have time to read and don't see myself reading those in the future. At the time, it was a good idea to actually buy those because I thought that I was going to be taking the time to actually read those books. But overall, I've got about, I'll show you all here in a second, I've got about 6 or 7 of the plastic totes full of books to sell. A few more items, but mainly what I'm selling is books. I'll take you all here and show you what I have and what I went through. Okay guys, you can see I have a lot of stuff up here for sale, and I'm gonna load this stuff up in my pickup and take it up there in a couple of days and set up a booth to sell these things. Like I said, the most of these totes you can see is books. And over here is a lot of DVD movies that I've already watched and don't plan on watching again. But mainly overall, these are all books in here. And there's a few things here like some camera bags and a lamp and things in there. And there's another tote down under that that has some odds and ends in it for sale. And I have a CB here for sale, a safe. This is a rack where you put your fishing rods up in this. I have an electric heater I'm not planning on using anytime. So just went through my things and gathered up what I thought that I would never need, what I never use, and put that together and take these up there and sell what I have and put the money to buy preps with. Because guys, right now, things are definitely looking like it's going to be a long, cold, hard winter, and maybe even a cold, hard decade, guys. It's not looking good. Lots of things are going on, and I think it's going to continue to get worse and worse. The last video I made was talking about some of the threats I see that we're going to have to face. And if you can sell anything you have that you don't need to buy preps with, then please go do that. I'm not telling you to sell your things and then go down in my description box and click my link to Patriot Pantry or whatever so I can get my affiliate commission. I'm saying sell what you have. If you're not using it, go to the store and buy all the rice, beans, canned goods, cooking oil, peanut butter, and things like that you can afford to buy. Anything you need, put that back and get it now, because in the near future, it's going to be more expensive and more difficult to find. Sorry guys, I'm out of breath. It is about 125 degrees in this building right now out here. It is hot today, it's humid today, and I'm dripping sweat from every orifice of my body. So I've been working, gathering these things up here. So I'm out of breath, I'm tired. But anyway guys, I want to make this quick video to let you all see what I'm doing. And you can, most likely, find at least a few items that you can sell to get some extra money to buy some extra preps and food items, some ammunition, maybe a new .22 rifle if you're lacking. Whatever you need, maybe you can find some things you're not using to sell and turn that cash into preps. But anyway guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, be sure to subscribe and turn notifications to be notified each time that I upload a new video. Thanks guys, I'm Nick Creekmore. I'm out of here. I'll see you guys in the next video.